This is R.V. Shekhar, practicing company secretary. In this video, I am going to discuss about the SEBI's action on Surana Corporation Limited today. It levied a fine of rupees 50 lakhs on former MD of Surana Corporation Limited. Surana Corporation Limited MD fined for inflating company's assets position and failure to comply with the LODR by SEBI. Company secretary also of Surana Corporation Limited was fined to rupees 1 lakh by SEBI for wrong certificate of corporate governance report and faulty composition of audit committee. So, company secretaries and listed companies have to be very careful, as they SEBI may fine later if they certify wrong corporate governance report, and also if they are constituted an audit committee which is faulty in nature. We had imposed rupees 50 lakhs on Surana Corporation former MD and rupees 1 lakh on company secretary Mr. Jay. SEBI on Friday slapped a total of rupees 50 lakh on Surana Corporation and its former managing director Vijay Raj Surana for inflating the company's asset position and non-disclosure of price sensitivity information to the SEBI. The regulator levied a penalty of rupees 25 lakhs each on Surana Corporation Limited SEL and Surana. Besides, it also levied a fine of rupees 1 lakh on company secretary Mr. Jain of the Surana Corporation Limited. What are the violations? SEBI, during the course of investigation, found that the companies did not have gold stocks and had merely falsified such stocks in the books of accounts and inflated its assets position with respect to gold stocks to the tune of rupees 294.23 crores. So, Surana Corporation dealing in various jewelry products, and the first allegation was it inflated the gold stocks falsely. Second allegation is, during search operation in the company, SEBI unearthed smuggled gold by SEL and seized various documents which fabricated the sales, purchases, stock documents for artificially inflating its assets value on paper and using same as a major security for availing loan from banks. So they fabricated these sales and purchases and stock documents mainly to avail loans from the banks. Surana Corporation Limited also engaged in inflating its assets, non-disclosure of price-sensitive information, sham transaction with related entities, contradictory statements of MD Surana, non-publication of auditor's report along with the financial reports within the stipulated time, which SEBI found that it is detrimental to the interest of the investors. The overstatement or false statement by Surana Corporation Limited lead to the violation of the prohibition of fraudulent unfair trade practice regulation, PFUTP, SEBI said in its order. Further, the company did not disclose the price-sensitive information pertaining to the raid on its premises to the stock exchanges. By doing so, the company failed to comply with the requirements of equity listing agreement and LODR, listing obligation disclosure requirements norms, SEBI said in its order. On company secretary Mr. Jain, SEBI said he had certified the corporate governance report that the company had complied with the requirements prescribed under the equity listing agreement in spite of various non-compliances, especially overlooking the faulty composition of audit committee. So allegation against the company secretary was this, and also non-reporting of faulty composition of audit committee is a misconduct on the part of Jain, company secretary, showing lack of desired level of competence, the regulator said. So, my dear professional company secretaries, so you have to be very careful. If you are working in a listed company, later SEBI may come against you and for formation of wrong audit committee like this, and also for certifying false corporate governance report. So as listed companies have to be very careful while working in the listed companies. Thanking you for watching this video. I request you to like, share and also subscribe my channel so that whenever I issue a new video, it will come to you directly. Thanking once again, R.V. Shekhar, practicing company secretary.